Welcome to Psv Neet-Academy, Krishnagiri. Here I am going to discuss about the Bohr's model of an atom. So here basically Bohr had three postulates about the atom. The first one is the electrostatic attraction between the nucleus and the electrons will be the cause for the circular motion of the electron. So here if you see, generally we know that the nucleus will be at the center and the electrons will be rotating around the center in a circular motion. So whenever there is a circular motion, there will be a centrifugal force acting. Someone has to provide that centrifugal force so that the electrons will be rotating in a circle. So here that cause for the centrifugal force will be the electrostatic attraction between the positive charged nucleus and the negative charged electron. So here I am taking charge of nucleus as Ze and electron it will be E. And let us assume that the electron is rotating in an nth orbit and the radius of the orbit is Rn. Coming to the second postulate. When electron is moving in an orbit, his consideration is that the angular momentum of the electron will be remaining conserved. And the angular momentum will be always in a quantized state. So here we can write the angular momentum mvr will be always quantized and it will be equals to nh upon 2 pi. So the first postulate is about the centrifugal force. The electrostatic force between the nucleus and the electron will be providing the centrifugal force. And whenever electron is rotating in orbit, its angular momentum will be quantized, which will be equal to nh upon 2 pi. And the last one is about stationary orbits. What are stationary orbits? So here electron is rotating around the nucleus. Generally when a body is moving, its energy will be continuously decreasing. According to our Newtonian mechanics or normal mechanics, when a body is continuously moving, its energy will be continuously decreasing. But here electron is continuously moving in a circular motion and its energy is going to be remaining constant. So here Bohr has defined certain orbits called as stationary orbits. When electrons are revolving in the stationary orbits, the energy of the electron will always remain conserved. So when electron is moving in stationary orbits, its energy will be remaining conserved. So let us see about what will be the amount of the radius of the stationary orbits and what will be the velocity of the electron when it is moving in the stationary orbit. So for that I will use the first two postulates. The first postulate is the electrostatic force between the nucleus and the electron will be providing the centrifugal force. So as we know that electrostatic force between two charges, if Q1 Q2 are separated by a distance r, then the electrostatic force we can give it as K into Q1 Q2 by r square. Here K value will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught if we consider a free space. And if we consider any other medium, K value will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon. Here the point is K will depend on the medium. But we are particularly talking about nucleus here. We will consider that there is vacuum between nucleus and the electron, nucleus and the stationary orbits. So here we can write K value which is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into charge of the nucleus Ze into charge of the electron E upon Rn square, radius of the nth orbit, will be the provider for our centrifugal force, which we can write it as Vn V square by R. Here I am taking nth orbit, so velocity in nth orbit, Vn square upon Rn. Now the second postulate where the angular momentum will be remain conserved. So here we can write m vn into rn for nth orbit, m into velocity in nth orbit into radius in nth orbit will be equals to nh upon 2 pi. So here from the second equation, if we make vn as a subject, we will get that velocity in nth orbit will be equals to nh upon 2 pi into m into rn. And then first equation, we can cancel out this Rn and Rn. Let us consider this as first equation and this as second equation. Now I am going to substitute the second equation in our first. So instead of Vn, we are going to substitute it as Nh upon 2 pi into m into Rn. So here the first equation will become 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Z e square upon Rn into m into Vn square. So square of this equation, this will become, sorry, here it will be equality, Vn square. Vn square will be n square h square upon 4 pi square m square into Rn square. Again, one more Rn, Rn will get cancelled out. So from here we will get the radius of the nth orbit, which will be equals to m into, here we can cancel out one more m. So this will be n square h square upon m into z e square. Again 4 pi will get cancelled out. So epsilon naught we can write it here into pi. So here the orbit number can change and z value can change depending upon that. All the remaining terms are universal constants. So if we substitute the values, we will get a final equation. Rn will be is equals to 0.529 into n square upon z, where this will be in angstroms. The radius of nth orbit will be in angstroms. 1 angstrom will be is equals to 10 power minus 10 meters. Okay, thank you.